Hello everyone. Keypads are most widely used in calculators, computer keyboards, mobile phones and various other applications. Now in this lecture, we will learn the working principle of keypads and how we can interface these keypads to the microcontrollers. Let's get started. So let's say we have a microcontroller and if we want to add 4 buttons to the microcontroller, we can add in this way. And if we want 4 more, I can add in this way. If I want 4 more, I can add this. This is a linear form of keypad where the GPIO required is equal to the available number of buttons. So for each button, we must provide a separate GPIO pins. So it is difficult if we require more number of buttons. Take an example of 4x4 keypad. It will be having 16 pins. So we must use a 16 GPIOs in our microcontroller to that dedicated keypad. So to solve this problem, we have a cool and efficient technique. That is, we will arrange these buttons in a matrix form so that it will fulfill our purpose of keypad. Let's see that. You can see the same 12 buttons are connected in a matrix keypad format and the out pinouts required is only 7, that is 4 rows and 3 columns. The first column is sorted with all the 1 terminals of buttons and second column is sorted with 1 set of terminals to the 4 buttons and third column is sorted with the 1 terminal of these 4 buttons. So each row such as R1 is connected to the 1 terminal of this button and this button, and similarly, row 2 is connected to other side of these 3 buttons, row 3 is connected to other side of these 3 buttons and row 4 is connected to other side of these 3 buttons. So, when we press a particular button, the corresponding column will be sorted with the respective row of the button. As you can see, C2 is connected to R1. And when I press this, C4 is connected to R1 and when I press this, C1 is connected to R1. So this is the logic that we are going to work on. Let's discuss about the logic behind this. And now you will be having a doubt, how can we identify which button is pressed and how signal is being transmitted? That we will understand using a simulation. This is the same keypad but in a module format. So, you can see the first row is A, B, C, first row is A, second row is B, third row is C and fourth row is D. And first column is 1, second column is 2, third column is 3. And what we will do is, initially we will make the columns as output in our microcontroller and rows as input in our microcontroller. This method is called row scanning technique. So let's see how this method works. When we turn on the column 1 using our microcontroller and if I press the 1 in our keypad, you can see the row 1 is high. So what we will do is we will turn on the column 1 and we will check for the row 1, row 2, row 3 and row 4. So if row 1 is high, we will get the data in our program as 1. And if row 2 is high, we will get the data as 4. And if row 3 is high, we will get the data as 7. And row 4 is high, we will get the data as star. And once after this, we will give a small delay in microseconds. And after this, we will turn off this and we will turn on this. That is column 2. And now again we will check for all these 4 rows. That is, we will scan through all these 4 rows which is high. If it is 1 is high, that means 2 is pressed. 2 is high, then it is 5 is pressed. And when we press 8, 3 will be high. And when we press 0, row 4 will be high. After that we will turn off this and we will turn on column 3. And when I press 3, row 1 will be high. And when I press 6, row 2 will be high and when I press 9, row 3 will be high, and when I press as, row 4 will be high. And again, I will continue the process in the program. In this way, I will turn off this and I will again turn on the column 1. And again, I will turn on this and this. As you can see, when the column 1 is high, and if any elements of column 2 or 3 is pressed, it will return only 0 to the respective rows. So you need not worry about the other keys, because only the rows corresponding to the column 1 will make the rows high. Vice versa method is also can be implemented, that is column scanning. That is, we will make this as output and we will scan through the columns for high. So what we will do is we will make the respective rows high in the reverse manner, and we will check the column out input to be high. That is called column scanning technique. So you can use either one of the method, but the procedure is same. So I hope you understood the internal arrangement of keypad and the working principle of keypad, and also you understood the row scanning and column scanning techniques. We will implement this in the upcoming lecture. Thanks for watching.